Welcome to iLecture Online. In our last example of this set, we need to strategize how to solve and simplify a problem like that. First of all, when I take a look at this right here, 15 divided by 5, that's equal to 3. So I would end up with the square root of 3, and I have a square root of 3 in the numerator. But then in the denominator, I have the square root of 25, but that simplifies to simply 5, which means I would end up with the square root of 3 in both terms, and then I can subtract them from each other. So that seems to be like the right strategy. If you don't see it right away, you can take it one step at a time. So let's first simplify this portion right there and see what we get. So this is equal to 2 times the square root of 3 divided by 25 minus 9 times the square root of 15 divided by 5, which is 3. And then if you still don't see it, that's okay. The next thing would be to perhaps separate these two. So this would be equal to 2 times the square root of 3 divided by the square root of 25 minus 9 times the square root of 3. And then you realize, well, the square root of 25 is simply 5. So this is equal to 2 times the square root of 3 divided by 5. In this case, we had minus 9 times the square root of 3. And now you say, well, they're alike. I have the square root of 3 here and the square root of 3 there, so I can go and subtract them. But we can't quite do that yet because we don't have a common denominator. So one more thing I need to do here. And you can see that sometimes the methodology kind of develops as you're working on it. Because you know the rules here, when you want to add or subtract, you need the same common denominator. So we need a 5 in the denominator. So what I need to do is multiply both the numerator and the denominator by 5, so I have a common denominator. So the next thing I would have, so this would be equal to 2 times the square root of the 3 over 5 minus 9 times 5, which is 45 times the square root of the 3 over 5. And now you can see that they're both over the same denominator. They both have the same radical expression. So now 2 minus 45 is equal to minus 43 times the square root of 3 all divided by 5. And that would then be the simplified form of my original expression. And my lovely wife had another great suggestion. She said, when you get to this stage right here, there's something else we could have done. Well, let's see what that means. Let's come up here and let's rewrite what we had over here. So we had 2/5 times the square root of 3 and minus 9 times the square root of 3. What we could have done here is simply factored out the square root of 3. So we can do that. This is equal to the square root of 3 times 2 over 5 minus 9. And then simply simplify this. Good idea. And again, to do that, we realize we need a common denominator here. So we're going to multiply both the numerator and the denominator by 5. So now we have a common denominator. And so this is equal to the square root of 3 times 2 over 5 minus 45 over 5. So this is equal to the square root of 3 times 2 minus 45, or 43 over 5. And of course, that's a minus. And then you could write it as minus 43 over 5 times the square root of 5. Typically, we like to write...
Square root of 3.
Oh, yep. Oop, let me go back. Okay. And then this could be written as minus 43 over 5 times the square root of 3. And of course, we get the exact same result as before. What's the advantage here? Well, we can simply pull out the radical and then just worry about this portion. And we don't have to have that radical in the rest of our problem getting in our way. Good suggestion. And that is how it's done.